After installing CADIO firmware on the ESP will create a Wi-Fi network for receiving the info file and configurations. We can open CADIO app and go to the configuration section and connect the phone to the ESP Wi-Fi network. In seconds, the connection will establish and the info file page will appear. Info file page will create the info file based on our preferences, and all codes will be internally created with the power of AI. The info file is created only once and cannot be edited unless the firmware is erased and reinstalled. In this video, we will explain the info file creation interface so we can make our custom info files for our projects. The first option in the info file is the config access point name, and here we can set the ESP configuration Wi-Fi network SSID, so the configuration network SSID can be anything instead of CADIO. In switches mode, we can select if the switches are normal switches, or press switches like push buttons, or three-way switches. From switches handling, we can set the priority of handling switches signals. If we select interrupts, the maximum priority is given, but if you are dealing with massive AC noises, you may need to try pooling method. We can select the switches wiring. There are two types, pull-up, which means that the switch is between the GPIO and GND, and a pull-up resistor is between the GPIO and VCC. The other type is pull-down, which means that the switch is between the GPIO and VCC, and a pull-down resistor is between the GPIO and GND. From relays mode, we can set the output on level, high or low. Software serial is used to connect another MCU to the ESP, using CADIO serial Arduino library. And 433 MHz feature allows controlling the devices using RF remote, and adding the support of wireless sensors. In protection, we can set the max safe temperature for the unit, and use a NTC sensor to manage the protection. The config button is a simple push button. All units must have a config button. Holding the config button for 3 seconds will activate the configuration mode, while holding it for 10 seconds will perform a factory reset, and a click on it will fire a fast restart. The indicators LEDs tell us about the unit status, active mode, and connection status. They are very important. Please use them. They will help you someday. In devices table, we can add up to 21 devices for any unit. We can select the device type and select its GPIOs. For example, I will add an on-off device and select GPIO 4 for it and GPIO 5 for its switch. Another device is a sensor on GPIO 12 and a DHT on GPIO 13, for example. That is how we can set our unit devices. After setting our unit info, the info file will be created and all codes will be internally generated with AI. After info file saved, the configuration page will appear. Here we enter our home router Wi-Fi network details, and now our unit is ready to use. In all next videos, I will share a screenshot of the info file settings for the unit I use in the video, so you can clone my unit settings and try it yourself. A lot of projects will be filmed soon. If you are interested, subscribe to our channel, and feel free to try CADIO, and feel free to contact us.